It's an exciting day. Of course, it's the Treva and Kevin Show, and we're happy to be here.
So good to be here this morning. You're looking happy today.
Thank you, and you're cheerful as
well. Yeah, we got to be.
That's all the time.
God blesses us so much, and we love to come in and share in the homes today.
Yes, well, we always talk about laughter, and we have a great time on our show. And so this show, it's going to be so much fun. So tell a friend, come on in. It's the Treva and Kevin Show.
Stay tuned. It's going to be a roar of laughs.
Laughter is great for the soul.
And you know, the truth is, everybody loves to see one smile.
Yes.
You know, it's a little curve that sets things straight. And there's nothing that's more fun than somebody who's humorous. And
yes.
All over the nation, they want to go watch all these comedians share. And so laughter is always a good thing.
It's always a good thing. And you know, on our show, we love the scripture, Proverbs 17 and 22. It talks about how a merry heart is like a medicine. It doeth good like a medicine.
Yes.
I mean, I think about all of the times we've laughed on this show and think about all of the exciting guests that we have had.
Yes.
But I wanted to share something with you all today. My dear friend, co-host, Kevin C. Kennedy, you're being honored.
Oh, my.
Coming up soon, Austin Peay State University.
Oh, yeah.
And let's talk about that.
Well, I was shocked, really, quite frankly, when I was called and was told that they gave myself and Rhonda, my wife, the Spirit of Austin Peay Award. And it puts us in a reflection mode, Treva.
Okay.
I remember when I got to Austin Peay, they have a road out front called College Street.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember driving in, I said, that truly is the road to success.
Mm-hmm.
And as I sat in those classes, I did not know where the road would take. And even now, today, we're on the television set here in Nashville broadcasting.
That's right.
And all I can say is what a wonderful journey it has been. They've been a big part of my life.
Yes.
And I remember going to the university, and I was challenged because some of those classes were so hard, and I was praying,
mm-hmm.
Lord, help me get past this. And I never will forget in my experience, many times I would pray, the grades would be, and my classmates say, Kevin, why are you praying? The test is over.
Mm.
And I used to say, my God can do all things.
All things.
So Austin Peay State University has been a grand place for me.
I agree.
I was walking across there, and that's where I made the decision to pursue the practice of law.
Right there.
Right there. I was in a speech class, and I said, well, I'm not smart enough to be a doctor. And I said, but I was a good talker.
Mm-hmm.
I should pursue law. And with that, I pursued it. And there's so many great professors. They poured their wisdom in life. And I remember talking to one day, and I said, tell me the truth. Do I have what it takes? Because if I don't, I'll entertain another career.
Yes.
And if I do, I want to take your words and go to the top.
I love it.
And that guy said, you know, Kevin, I might have seen brighter students. I said, well, praise the Lord.
Oh, my.
But he said, I never saw a student with more tenacity.
And determination.
Come on.
And you have to have that determination.
You can do it. And, you know, one other thing that's interesting.
Okay.
So when I graduated with honors. That was something surprising to me. And doors opened up.
Mm-hmm.
The next year, I got to teach at Austin Peay. I was teaching at Austin Peay at 22 years old.
My goodness.
Is that amazing?
That is amazing.
And Austin Peay, where I met Rhonda, my future wife. And so Rhonda got her degree, and I got a master's, and Rhonda got her master's. Rhonda's going to be honored on this same occasion. And Rhonda won Tennessee Principal of the Year a few years ago, and Austin Peay honored her as an outstanding alumni. So what does this award really mean to us? Boy, it is going to be some kind of celebration.
Yes, it is. I tell you.
And so I can't wait to experience the night when I look back. So many of the people that helped me along the way, it makes me want to help others.
That's right.
Along the way.
Along the way.
And point the glory to Christ.
Back to Christ. And it's a blessing because I was out in the Clarksville community.
Come on.
And there's a pastor who is a dear friend of ours, and yes, she's a friend of yours. Her name is Pastor Catherine Walker, and I shared with her about this big, joyous, this celebratory event, and she said, I'm so happy for Kevin, and so she did a video. So coming up, there will be a video that you will see from our friend, Pastor Catherine Walker, and you know,
amazing.
She's the songbird. I call her the songbird of the South.
Come on now,
I know. And so she did do some singing.
Amen.
And there's a special song she says that you are going to love.
Yes, I know, Catherine and I, we went to school together, and then as we proceeded on, I was getting my master's with her husband,
okay,
who had the church going, and God called him home.
Wow.
And she had a decision, and she took it up and rose up an amazing lady, amazing woman of God.
I love it. Okay, well, don't go anywhere. We're going to check out that video. And coming up, our dear friend Cintoria Franklin is with us, and we're going to have a great time today. We're going to share some humorous stories today, because I've got a few. You've got a couple.
I need to tell a few on you.
And also, listen, we got to break out in that dance.
Oh, no.
Okay? All right.
We'll be laughing.
We'll be back with more Treva and Kevin.
Stay tuned. It's going to be fun.
All right. We've caught up again with Pastor Catherine Walker. And, of course, we know she's the songbird of the South. And Kevin Kennedy, you're being honored in Clarksville at Austin Peay State University for your many, many accomplishments. And so, Pastor Catherine, you're going to grace us with a song.
Every time I sing this song, Kevin, God is moving obstacles out of your way. You're going to win.
Ride out the storm. God is there with you. He'll never leave you. You're not alone. You're hurting now. But your morning is coming. Hold on to Jesus. You can ride out the storm.
Back, laughter is great for the soul.
Absolutely.
I had to take it up another level.
Take it up two levels.
Well, that's what happens when your special friend is here today, ladies and gents. Our dear friend Cintoria Franklin, I mean, she is an amazing woman in Nashville, and we love her dearly. She's a friend of our show, so welcome.
Welcome.
And of course, I would be remiss. She did my hair, and I love it.
Yeah.
And she's a stylist. She's an activist. And we're here to talk about just God's goodness, His grace,
amen,
and the things that make us smile.
Yes.
So let's talk, change it. We're going to keep it light, because that's what it's all about. It's the morning. It's in the morning here.
Okay. Testify. What are you thinking about today?
So look, when you done been through so much in your life, have to find ways to bring out the light that's within
you. Amen.
You know, something is like, it's ready to be revealed.
Yes.
And one of the healthiest things that I always do, and I always tell people it's a great way to get through a lot of the past pain, is to laugh. Find ways to laugh your butt off. That's okay.
Okay.
Yes, it's okay. Yes.
She's got a contagious
laugh. I like that.
And so ways I do that, you know, I deal with, you know, finding ways to laugh is I may dance, I may tell jokes,
yes,
I may like have a family gathering. We just, you know, look at pictures. We, you know, it's just fun things to
amen
do.
Amen.
And I know it's healthy. And it's a contagious, it should be contagious.
It is. Laughter is contagious.
Yes.
Because you never know what somebody may be experiencing.
Well, the truth is, in life, we're going to have many ups and downs. Mm-hmm. So we are called to bring some light.
Yeah.
That's and
right.
some joy.
And the funny.
We serve the King of Kings.
Yeah.
His news is the greatest news ever.
That's right.
So what
that's
do you all like to do for fun besides, say, okay,
she's
besides
a dancer.
Working?
No.
She's a no, you're a dancer.
Well, they accuse me of dancing from time to time. That
okay.
is true.
Okay.
But you know, you can never go up and start dancing without people starting to laugh.
Yeah.
Is it true?
Yeah.
So
yes.
you can be in the grumpiest mood ever.
That's
somebody
right.
gets up and say they're going to break some mood.
That's right.
Everybody's going to start
and
laughing.
I know whenever there's a dance floor, you're the first on the floor.
Well, you know, I don't know how I ended
yes.
up with that. And you know, I never had a dance lesson.
Really?
So I used
really?
To get on TV and watch Soul Train. And they say, Kevin, are you watching Soul Train? I said, get out of here. Soul Train's watching me. And I said, you seen that movie? That Michael Jackson had the
okay,
moon.
Okay, the moonwalk.
He got it from Kevin Kennedy.
Oh,
you know?
My.
Yeah.
Back in the day.
He got rich on it.
Oh,
all
my
All I
goodness.
Can do is just get a little
oh
imitation going
okay.
on.
Okay. So what do you like to do?
I like to do Chicago-style stepping.
Oh, my.
Chicago-style mm-hmm. stepping.
Oh now, my. Look.
Yes.
When I go to these, it's called stepping sets.
Yes.
And they have it on first Saturdays. I'm an amateur now.
Amateur.
But the dance is so beautiful.
Amen.
And the men, they get out, and you could be a stranger here.
Yes.
They pull you on that floor, they get the stepping.
Okay.
You may not know what you're doing, but
yes.
they're going to guide you.
Amen.
But it's
I love
dance.
It. Yes. I love it.
I got to tell you, I was in Las Vegas at a big, big lawyer convention, the biggest one in the nation, and they happened to have a gigantic dance contest for the entire world.
Oh, my.
And I went, and these people were glittered from top to toe. Magnet, and you say, Kevin, what's holding you back?
Mm.
And when you go out and you look at them, they were all so happy.
Yeah.
Experience in life.
That's right.
Sharing the joy.
That's right.
And so I'm standing out here with all these lawyers, and lawyers can be grumpy. Hello, coming
yeah.
in.
Mm-hmm.
They're suing and getting sued. And then all of a sudden, they're just standing in amazement watching these people in beautiful outfits
yes.
having the time of their
yeah.
life.
And you know, another thing is we can't take ourselves too literal, like just
Come
too
on.
Serious
yes.
all the time.
Yes.
We have to be able to laugh
yes.
at ourselves.
Yes.
And
the Bible
yes.
says
That's
there's
right.
a time to laugh and a time to dance.
I believe
Is it
that.
Time to do it?
Oh,
Hold
yes.
on.
Hey.
Don't
yes.
get her too much.
Yes.
She
yes.
will be gone and get a little rhythm.
I love it.
You know, you cannot do it.
Yes.
Without making somebody happy.
Right. That's right.
And I love to share the love
uh-huh.
of Christ. What is it? We have so much to be happy yeah. about.
That's right.
And we've all been to a valley.
And you say, when's the last time you laughed at yourself? When's the last time?
Last time I was watching
I remember one time I was walking down the street, and I was probably in the seventh grade, and there was these guys, and they were outside, and I thought they were cute, but I was so handsome, and I was so
yes.
nervous. And I said, don't let me fall. Don't
right.
let me fall. And what do you think I did when I passed
no,
by
you
them?
Did you fall?
I fell on my face.
Oh,
I said,
man.
Oh, my. And no one helped me at all.
Oh, my
but I had to laugh.
Oh,
I had to laugh at myself.
Well,
it's embarrassing sometimes.
Yeah. Everybody that has ever fallen, the first thing you do if you're an adult, you're looking around to see
yeah.
who's
yeah.
because, and if there's others and you didn't get hurt, they are laughing
yes.
because it's kind of funny. No one won't see anybody get hurt.
Yeah.
But it is so true.
It is.
And
Cintoria.
I think the best medicine is either you laugh or you dance it off.
Mm-hmm. Say laugh to keep from crying.
Laugh to, yes.
Wow.
Laugh to keep from crying.
And dance
or have
it
that
off.
Funny friend that's in your
yeah.
life. A
yeah.
friend that,
I think
that's hilarious.
Yes. So many people love me being around them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And like they say, I have this thing. One woman called me a glory carrier because I bring a light. I've never
Amen.
Heard of that. That's
yes.
the first time I've ever heard
it's good.
Like that.
Wow.
I can see
but,
it.
Like, you have to be the light
mm-hmm.
for people.
And the yeah. purpose why we wanted to do this show, because so many people are going through a hard time,
depressed,
or they're down,
confused,
they're depressed.
Hurt.
And when's the last time you turned on the television and people were talking
right.
about something other than sadness
yes.
or things that, because everybody out there, a lot of people are depressed. So how
yeah.
can we talk about the joy of, that the Lord brings? Because the
I
joy
mean,
of the
yes.
Lord, He is our strength.
Yes.
And that's what I gathered from you just the other day, just
yeah.
sitting in your chair, in your salon. It's like, even though we've gone through all of these things in our lives, still make time to laugh,
yes.
enjoy the
I
great
like
times.
Yes.
And we've had some great rides coming to the studio, Kevin, together,
yes.
where we were just laughing, talking about
the time
positive
went by.
Things.
We never even
That's
knew
right.
where we were.
That's
yes.
right.
We're kind of zoned out.
Yes.
And I can't get away from this Chicago style
Uh-oh.
Step.
Hey.
I was thinking about that music. I could even hear the beat.
You
y'all
can.
Hey.
Look
okay.
at her smile.
Hey.
Now, if you turn turned her loose out here. Okay. Nobody okay. would watch that.
Well, we might have to do it. We might have to
just
do it.
Just a little clap and a little laughter.
Yes.
And you know, in the Bible, David danced before the Lord. And he was a man after God's own heart.
So do you guys ever get in the mirror and just start dancing?
Oh, yeah.
All
yeah.
the time?
Well, and you know, I told you I won the dance contest at the high school. I'll never defeated.
Oh, my
Hello,
God.
Come in.
Until you met Treva.
Oh, no.
No. Just playing.
Yeah, Treva's a good dancer now. She'll trick you.
Yeah.
But I self-taught. Of course, you know, I didn't have funds to go watch all this. And then, you know, even when I did Dancing with the Stars, they brought the professional dancers in with me. And I said, well, that's good, but let me show you how it's really done. Do you really believe that?
Yeah.
So it was all good and fun. And, I still love to dance.
Wow.
So I got to see his moves, Treva.
Body move.
Okay, let's try a little bit of that.
Calm her down. We'll be going to, we got to have the music for y'all to fully express the joy of the Lord.
Okay. All right. Well, when we come back, we're going to take a break. And when we come back, legal question corner
okay,
time,
let's hurt him.
And maybe we'll dance a little during the break. We'll see what happens. Okay.
Oh, you will. Sure.
We'll be right back.
Stay tuned. Can't wait.
We're back.
We're here. Hello, come in.
Laughter is good.
Laughter's always
good. Great.
I got a little story to tell, Treva. So, you know, there's this really sophisticated New York lawyer.
Oh.
He's driving through the South, and he runs in, and this little country kind of sheriff pulls him over. He walked up to the car, and he said, sir, give me your license. You roll through that stop. Well, the sophisticated New York lawyer looks, hey, man, this guy don't know the law like me. He said, I tell you what. I'm going to get out of the car, and if you can explain the difference to me with slow down or stop, I'm going to let you write me this ticket. Mm-hmm. And if you can't explain it, you're going to let me go. Country policeman said, get out, sir. So he gets out of the car, and as soon as he turns around, he pulled his billy club, and he went to wailing on the lawyer, beating him down. He said, now, do you want me to slow down or do you want me to stop? My cameraman.
Oh,
that was good. It was
slow
good.
Down.
It'll
okay.
catch up with
all
you.
All right. In the parking lot.
Go ahead.
That's right. In the parking lot. I love
somebody
it.
Needs to take
I got
to get a new
house. Oh, my God.
That's good. Say you love Jesus. Okay, let's get to our serious question.
Okay. Legal question corner time.
Okay. Preston Kennedy.
All right, hit me.
Okay. When it comes to visitations, right?
Yep.
Okay, do you think the father or the mother, it don't matter, I guess, who the parental right is.
Yeah.
Do you think they have a right to see the child even though they don't pay child support?
Well, y'all make a real good argument. Come on, and say, well, he's not responsible under the law right here, and I don't want to let him see. That's the natural. If you want to visit, you need to pay.
Yes.
If you want to go to the movie, you got to pay.
You've got to pay.
If you want to go skating rink, you got. Well, guess what? Tennessee law is adverse to that because they're going to say you got to pay the money irregardless if you see or visit the child. And if you really didn't think that was fair, you can go to your legislature and say we need to do something about that.
Okay.
Because, you know, there's some of these men who've never paid one penny.
Right.
know, with the famous, oh, I'm going to take care of my kid. You know, I'm going to take care of my kid. Well, we heard you say that, but your words don't follow your actions.
Right.
And if we went to the child support court right now, if I took you ladies with me, standing room only.
Wow.
And so there's so many people that will not carry that responsibility. And having a child is a big responsibility. You make an excellent point and say praise the Lord for the single mothers that raise these young kids into our policemen and our firemen and our soldiers, because somebody's there spending time. On the converse, you know, there's another argument. I've heard judges say over the years, Kevin, even a bad daddy is better than no daddy. If daddy's being irresponsible, he's going to say, well, I've been down on my luck. Well, you've been out of a job for 10 years. Okay. But so I hear all the arguments, but it was an excellent issue to bring up. Mm-hmm. And that's my position. I can tell you what the law says and what would I say. And so moms and dads, the moral of this story is teach your children to be responsible.
Yes.
And, you know, truth of the matter, children need both parents.
Yes.
They need a male figure in their life, and they need a female
They
figure.
Do.
That's correct.
That's a great. That's an excellent question.
And
I thought it was an excellent answer.
Yeah.
What'd
yeah,
you
I thought
say?
So. Yes.
Say
and,
amen.
Well,
the courts, you know, in the courts, they're full. And
they
these
are
cases,
cram-packed.
Yeah.
And, I mean, I know several who are going through that right now. So even our prayers go out to, you know, in that situation because people are having to deal with that. And when it's my payment that's coming in to take care of this child, is it coming? And so that's a lot. That's a lot of stress for the mother or the father. Depends on, you know, the person.
It's the biggest attack on our democracy in the nation.
Yeah.
Because the strongest thing this nation has is the family.
Mm-hmm.
And then strong families make a strong church, a strong church makes a strong community. You break the family, you're broken the whole thing down.
Okay. So now I have a one-liner, a joke.
No, let's
We're
see.
We're going to go back.
Tell
okay.
Tell her to try to
let's
catch
see.
Up.
Let's
So
play catch up, Treva.
Okay. I recently decided to sell my vacuum cleaner. But it was just gathering too much dust.
I knew she was going to come with that. I saw that one coming a mile away.
Hey.
When is the last time you picked up a vacuum cleaner?
Yesterday.
Ooh. Yeah.
What about you?
It don't show.
Oh, my goodness.
Don't you know? It's been a while since I did that. And but I do love a commitment to excellence and people that keep their house and their offices clean.
Well, I tell you what, we're going to take this quick break. And when we come back, we have some dance moves.
No.
Because it's time to get on the dance floor.
I got to show Kevin.
All right. Treva and Kevin show. We'll be back. Cintoria.
Keep them hidden,
and
Treva.
Kevin. All
right. Well, you're going to get in, too.
Is everyone doing good?
Open your eyes. We're all great.